Pharma analyst at Prabhudas Lilladher is joining us right now. Sujit, good morning. Good to have you here. Prashant this side. Slew of pharma earnings. Lupin reports today, so let's start with that. Our estimates, which will come up on air, show that sales will grow about 25-26% year on year. Q1, sales were up about 36-37% year on year. So there is a significant slowdown. Can you start with that?
I think the difference could be coming from Cymbalta. So Q1, I think they have pushed quite a lot about Cymbalta because that was a last exclusivity that quarter till May. So that benefit has come in terms of top line growth last quarter or Q1. And that could also impact the margin of this year, though we are expecting around similar line of margin of around 32%, which they achieved in Q1 too. But my fear is that there could be some shelf stock adjustment, and that could reduce margin by, say, anything between 3-4%, if there is any.
No, could you repeat that? You're saying margins could come off sharply. Because of what?
Margin could come down sharply because what happened is that whatever you have pushed in the last month or of your exclusivity period, and after that when competition raging up because of the new competitors getting in, so they are discounting the price more aggressively. So what will happen is that at the end of the month or at the end of the quarter, when you are getting the money back from your distributor, they will be giving you the money at the reduced rate. So whatever the price you have booked sales in Q1, you have to adjust that price to the lower rate. So as a result of it, the difference will be coming as a shelf stock adjustment. And that could reduce the margin in Q2.
Right. Quarter on quarter, what kind of margin, EBITDA margin contraction are you expecting overall?
See, I'm expecting, my official number definitely is expecting the similar kind of achievement for the company because I believe this quarter they might be getting benefit from...
So about 400 basis points lower margins, quarter on quarter?
Anything between 300-400, that is the maximum possibility of contraction.
Okay, all right. Got that. So, they launched a couple of products as well in the quarter. Right?
That's right.
But you think, Cymbalta, Niaspan, these essentially going off the exclusivity period and essentially getting more competition, mm-hmm. that would do more harm?
Yes. I believe, there are few products for the company which they are enjoying. Being a single generic guy or, among the two or three generic competition. I think those products are getting crowded day by day. So that could impact the top line growth and margin over a period of time. Unless until they bring new product like, large product like Niaspan or Tricor. I think they will maintain a smaller exclusivity business like, say, Zymaxit. Kind of product?
For the stock, would quarterly earnings matter or the love affair will continue irrespective? I mean, even if the numbers came a little lower than what is expected, would be a problem?
For a big company like Lupin, I don't think it could matter much. But definitely it will disappoint the holders or the guys who are holding the company on a trading purpose. But overall, the bullishness remains in the company given the kind of fact that they have a very strong pipeline of limited competition drugs for next 2 years and the kind of approval they have been getting on a consistent basis. I don't think it will have much cause of concern for Lupin.
Ranbaxy reports as well today, Sujit. Are you tracking that? Or, it doesn't really matter with the Sun essentially going to be merging it in the future?
I think what they are expected to do is that, see, generally their U.S. revenue is roughly around $120 million per quarter. So I think this quarter for Deoband, they might be adding another, 60 to 70 million revenue on the top. So that could be the upside for the company, and that could increase the margin too.
No, but you said they, usually it's $120 million. This quarter it could go up to, you said it could go up?
Yeah, it could go up to the level of, say, maximum $60 to $70 million.
160 to 170?
It could be around anything between, 170 to $190 million kind of revenue for this quarter from US for RAN bags.
Okay, you think it will be material? For the stock?
Given the financial condition.
RAN bags will move in the same ratio. Yeah.
Yeah, given the kind of company's fundamental, I think definitely it's a big help for the company's top line numbers as well as margin, because exclusivity product have a pretty high margin vis-a-vis the normal generic. So definitely it is very helpful for the company's top line growth, margin, cash flow, and overall reduction of debt going forward.
Yeah. There was a report, I'm sure you read it, in the Business Standard yesterday, which said that it could lose its Nexium opportunity if it doesn't get FDA approval before the end of November. What did you make of it, Sujit?
No, I don't have any news or any update from the company. I don't think that could be a possibility, because there have been a lot of speculation in media. But every time there is a speculation, management came out pretty strongly with confidence that they will maintain the exclusivity of the product. I mean, Deovan is the same case. They were supposed to get it 2012, but it never happens, and they got it after so many months. So I think that could be the same case with Nexium, because they are also the similar line of argument they have. So it could be the case that they might be outsourcing API from third party, and they could go ahead with their formulation manufacturing in home labs and get the product out in US.
Sujit, thanks very much for your time. Good talking to you, and hope to catch up with you once the numbers are actually out. Tomorrow you got Dr. Reddy's, and then a few others after that. So pharma packed sort of week in terms of earnings. Mahantesh Sabarat, Deputy Head Research at SBI Cap Securities, is with